Hey boys and girls, welcome to my channel. I'm For Classic and welcome to Benchart. So for today we are in here to benchmark a game released 6 months ago, by the time of the release of this video of course, Rage 2. So Rage 2, when it was released, it wasn't really compatible with Phantom 2 X4 CPUs, but it seems that they did remove the denouval behind this game and the game magically started to work on Phantom 2 CPUs. So I bet that denouval was the culprit in here, because denouval sometimes requires SSE 4.2 in order to run. So let's start with the settings before going into any detail about the game itself. So these graphical settings of this game, it is really stupid, because most of the settings don't do anything. So my recommended settings in here, it is 75% of resolution scaling, which is something between 900p and 720p, unfortunately. I'm keeping anisotropic detail and geometric detail. Global illumination, I did benchmark with this on, but it seems that actually have an impact in performance to frames, so I will play it with global illumination off. Depth of field, I'm going to keep it off. SSAO, I'm going to keep it on low. There is a slight difference in performance if you choose medium high or ultra, but I really need those frames. Anti-aliasing, I love TAA, so I don't care what's the performance cost. It is not that much, so I'm going to use TAA. Player self-shadow, no impact. Dynamic reflections, I'm pretty sure these will have an impact where there is water or puddle, so I'm going to keep it off. Shadow resolution, it is the biggest impactor in here in the performance, so I'm going to keep it on low. Shadow lights, on impact during the night. Shading quality, surprisingly, doesn't affect the performance, despite it affects the visuals. Soft particles, I'm going to keep it on. And fidelity FX, which is recently added to the game, I decided to keep it on because it helps a lot to make TAA sharper. So yeah, the requirements. These guys ask for a Ryzen 3 8GB of RAM and an AMD R9 280 with 3GB of VRAM. What can I say? We are completely below the minimum requirements. We shouldn't be playing this, but yet we are able to do it. With my custom settings, with 75% of resolution scaling, and even with global illumination on, I was having an average of 36 frames per second and the 1% wall of 23. But most of the game was playable between the 30s to 40s, which is acceptable. As for the low settings with 1080p, the game was hovering between 25 to 40 frames per second. But I did prefer to go with the lowest resolution, I mean with 75% of resolution scaling and having extra details, especially the geometric detail, and also having frame rates between the 30s and the 40s. The 1% low, it is lower because I have, for some reason, more stuttering in some of the stuff, some of the fights that I had, which was much more violent than with the low settings, I don't know why. But it was much more violent, much more action, and actually the game did stutter more because of that, I believe, and so the 1% low, it was lower, but the average of the game, it was mostly between 30 to 40 frames per second, and that's why I'm playing this game with a gamepad, which is kind of bad, but I don't feel comfortable playing with mouse and keyboard when you are having between 30 to 40 frames per second, even on an FPS game. So that's why I'm using the gamepad. But anyway, I know that most of the users will use mouse and keyboard, but it's just a thing on my own. I don't feel comfortable playing with mouse and keyboard at 30 frames per second or 40s. I need more frame rate to play decently with the mouse and keyboard. So that's why I decided to go with the gamepad. So what about the game? So if you play the first Rage, these have nothing to do with the first Rage. Yes, not even the ambience, alright? Nothing relatable at all. Probably the factions, alright? It's the only thing related in this game, it is the factions. So, this game is developed by Avalanche Studios and ID Software. So, ID Software was the developers of the first game, so all the action behind this game, it felt pretty much the same, much more brutal and frenetic. So all the action of the FPS genre, it is here, but it ends there. The similarities ends there, because all the rest was developed by Avalanche, and the Avalanche, it is the developers behind games like Mad Max and Just Cause, and the ID Software are the developers of games like Doom, Wolfenstein, and, you know, pretty much all the biggest FPS games focus on frenetic action. ID Software was the developers. And so, yes, that's it. But the thing is, since this game it is developed by Avalanche, the similarities with Mad Max, it is huge. I liked Mad Max, honestly. I really enjoyed Mad Max, but I haven't finished the game. This is because it was too damn repetitive. I really enjoyed the combat system of Mad Max. I really enjoyed of traveling through the map in Mad Max. It was awesome. But, guys, it was too damn repetitive. And Rage 2, it is, again, committing the same problems. Rage 2, it is an excellent game, great graphics, great engine, great sound, great gameplay, especially in these events with first-person action. It is amazing, and there are a lot of stuff that is completely equal to Mad Max. But, come on, guys. It is still damn repetitive, and most of the people that complains about this game are the repetition of this game, the fact that you are doing the same thing over and over and over again, just like Vaz in Far Cry 3 did told us, and issues with the game. Alright, but the issues, what I found, it was more relatable with the launch of the game, so I believe that most of the stuff it is fixed, but the gameplay can't be saved. It is just too damn repetitive, and that really hurts the game, alright? So that's one of the things that you should know about Rage 2. It is just too damn repetitive and big. So the game can be bought from $59.99 on Steam. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to gather a discount from Green Man Gaming, so you really need to pay the same price as Steam if you decide to buy through there. But if you buy through Green Man Gaming, you will be supporting the channel, which is something that I always appreciate a lot, because it helps us to get more games, especially at launch, where most of the people want to know if you should buy or not, and what's the performance. So it would be a great help if you buy games through the links that I do provide on the description of the video, and usually Green Man Gaming have a discount, but again, it is not discounted by the time of the release of this video, so probably you should buy through Steam instead of Green Man Gaming. But again, if you buy through Green Man Gaming, you will be supporting the channel. But anyway, I shouldn't really recommend you to get this game for $59.99. This game has 6 months right now, I'm pretty sure. If you wait a little bit longer, you will find the game on a decent sale. So I do recommend you to wait for a sale if you want to get this game. So guys, that's all that I want to talk about Rage 2. Hope you keep enjoying the rest of the gameplay, and I do hope to see you soon. Goodbye.
Walker, Dr. Kvothir is still out there, and we have to find him. to Arc 416A. You have successfully installed ID Accession Shatter. The Shatter Accession is a forward lunge that unleashes a powerful kinetic force capable of stripping armor and displacing enemies and objects. Again. Good. Use Shatter to strip the target's armor. Your Shatter Accession training.
Hey, that arc was brimming with some amazing gear.
Yeah, I know. I'm pretty jealous right now, so keep a lid on it, will ya?
Walker?
So, there's a big tower just standing here. It's got authority written all over it.
Sounds like a sentry tower. Leftovers from the war. Usually they will fire at anything that comes too close, so be careful if you're gonna go for it.
sensors are now in average deployment.